Hi, Mike Redding here, and welcome back to usingtechnologybetter.com. In today's video, I want to just introduce you to a new concept in presentations called Sway by Microsoft. And this is a great opportunity to get your students using a different program, which will just save you a little bit of death by PowerPoint. So Sway is still in preview mode, but anyone can access it. You just need to sign in with your Microsoft account. If you don't have one of those, you can get one for free. Just go to Microsoft and sign up. In Sway, you can have a look at a few different examples of Sways that have been created, but basically it's just a different kind of a layout of information. Now these can have all sorts of embedded media, such as photos, videos, text, and so on. And you'll see down here, if I just move to the next Sway, it just sort of slides across the screen nice and neatly. Now you can set up different layouts and see how those work. And it's all just on the inside just here. So if I go into my sways just here, you'll see that you can create a new sway or you can import one from a Microsoft document, PowerPoint or PDF. Here's one that I've imported from a PowerPoint slide that I had. Now I want to just show you this because it's not an exact science and it doesn't come across seamlessly. So what it does is it takes your slides and it just pulls apart all the bits and pieces that are on there and puts them into these different cards. So on the front page I had a title, I had some text about how people could contact me, I had my logo, and I had a couple of images down here as well. So basically what that did was grabbed all of those different aspects and then pulled them all together. If I was to go in here and preview that, it would kind of look a little bit like this. So at the moment I've got the title that came in here, some of the text is just down the bottom, it wasn't great. This one here is actually sliding down the screen, different layout. So if I keep going down, you'll see the logo comes up, you'll see that some images come up, and so on. So once again, not the best way to do this. Now if I wanted to create one, it's very simple. All I need to do is go to create a new sway. And you'll see that there's some options in here. It's very user-friendly, it's very intuitive. If you wanted to put a title sway, you can just type it in there, you can change the background and so on. You can just drag and drop contact. You can just drag and drop content into this, which is really easy. You can also choose the different type of cards you want. So you can have over here picture cards, video cards, you can embed tweets and all sorts of things in here. You also have different slideshows and you can have groups and stack your cards as well, which you can play around with. So to insert something, you simply just click on the insert button up here. You can see that you can get suggested things from Sway. If you had some text already typed in, it would then do a search around the text that's in there and suggest things. You can pull your text or images or videos out of OneDrive, OneNote. You can see here there's also Facebook, Bing and so on. If you click on here, add a source, basically what you can do is let Sway know where you'd like to get information from, and they're taking advice on that at the moment. You also have the ability here, when you click insert, to upload straight off your computer. If you have a look at the cards, we've been through here, had a look at different card designs. If you click the little plus button just here, you can choose text, headings, pictures, and upload as well. The design tab just across the top here is the look. You'll see that a lot of these are coming soon, so it's still in preview mode. But if we click on the style, you'll see that you can change the fonts, the colors, the background, and so on. So it's all just there for you. When you come in here to insert, you'll also notice that there's a search function up here. And if you were searching for whales, for instance, you'll notice that the search results here are tagged with Creative Commons licenses. So this is all just searching Bing images. Now, Sway is also available on the iPhone, not available on the Android, but it's just another great way to create content, to have your students creating ideas, synthesizing their thoughts, processing and analyzing, and then presenting. So hopefully that's been a help. Just go over to sway.com, check it out, and then let us know in the comments section what you think. We'll see you in the next video.